I'm doing great. How are you doing?
I'm fabulous. So I know you said a fabulous swim tonight in the 100 of the year, but obviously you have some comeback speed I saw there.
Yeah, I think that was the best time for me, so I'm pretty happy.
Yeah! Walk me through that swim.
I mean, it's the first meet back. It's always hard to have the first meet after, you know, a long summer, taking a little time off. I finally have my stroke back underneath me. It took me almost like 2 months to get that back. I'm finally swimming with some rhythm. That's really important for me. And I mean, it felt good. I felt like I had some easy speed going out. I was able to bring it home. So, bodes well for, I think, my 200.
Yeah, well, you're in a good position. It's been really fun to watch you because you have a lot of guts. When people didn't count you in to be an Olympian, and when UC Davis gave up their men's swimming program, you had to dig deep. Tell us a little bit about that experience.
Yeah, I mean, you could say maybe I was at a disadvantage without a team, but at the same time, I mean, I had a lot of one-on-one coaching. You know, I had a really great coach. We managed to work around things, you know, do things that were kind of unique that you probably couldn't do with a larger team. So, I mean, you could play both sides. You could say I had an advantage. You could say I had a disadvantage. You know, I love being in Davis. That's why I didn't leave. I'm not going to leave now. I feel really at home there. The whole community there is great. I have a lot of support there. You know, it definitely sucks, you know, cutting to the men's team, but there's still a women's team there, so at least there's something. But, you know, I just love the university. Yeah, I love going to school there. I like being there, and, you know, great coach. Things worked out, so.
Well, that's fabulous. Well, obviously, you're still swimming, so
yeah.
Hopefully you get some sponsorships along the way here.
I mean, that definitely makes it a little easier, but, I mean, I still love it. I think if I didn't, I wouldn't be swimming anymore.
Uh-huh.
You know, the Olympics is kind of like a dream. You go to that. If I didn't like it anymore, I'd be done, but I'm still enjoying myself. You know, I still have fun in practice, working hard. I just want to keep getting better. Once I stop getting better, I think I'll be done. So
you have world championships in December.
Yeah, you know, that's really exciting. I've never swam a short course meters race before, so that'll be a first. Part of me is really excited because I feel like I never had that great of a college career, so if I can get some good short course swimming in, that'll be great. Part of me is nervous because I think I didn't have a good college career because I'm not that great at short course, but it's going to be fun. There's going to be different guys that were in London, get to meet some more members like Team USA. I'm just looking forward to it.
That's great. And what's your plans for the future?
Honestly, I don't know. I'm going to try and go back to school at some point, try and work that in with training, but right now I'm just kind of enjoying the ride.
Well, congratulations on a great summer and good luck in the upcoming year.
Thank you.
All right.